Alrighty, everybody, thank you so much for tuning in to the CW39 Houston's Digital Dive. Right now we have a very special guest in our digital studio. So can you first tell our viewers your first and last name and your title, please?
Sure. My name is Cynthia Nunes Colbert, and I am the President and CEO of Catholic Charities.
And what exactly is Catholic Charities?
Well, we are a faith-based multi-service agency serving a 10-county region. We provide a wide array of services that help people who are in crisis or need basic needs, all the way to helping people gain stability and self-sufficiency.
We know poverty is a major issue impacting many Houstonians and people across the country and even the world. So talk to us about the conversation you had earlier and your work that you're doing to bring awareness to this issue.
So January is called National Poverty Awareness Month, and we believe that it starts with educating people to bust the myths about who is in poverty, why they get there, and the fact that we can help people out of poverty by this community coming together. In Houston, the number is around 20%, almost 21% live in poverty at the federal poverty level. In Harris County, it's 16%. But what we know is that for a family of four, in the federally poverty level is $30,000. So think about it, $30,000 for a family of four, and that's before deductions, trying to make it on health care, transportation, their rent, everything else. So families need a little bit of a leg up. And there are a lot of barriers that keep families living in poverty, and agencies like Catholic Charities and many others in the Houston region are working together to help people on a path out of poverty.
How do those numbers you just mentioned about the poverty level here in Houston, how do those numbers, you know, tee up to other numbers across the country or,
Sure. You
know, in other major cities?
Our poverty rates here in Houston and Harris County are higher than those for the state, which I believe is around 11%, and definitely higher than that for the entire country.
That's pretty alarming.
It is, and that's why, we are trying to raise awareness. Everyone can do something to help our neighbors, and by volunteering, by donating, by knowing more about poverty and how to help people.
Well, here we are based on community-based solution journalism. So talk to us about, you know, some other ways people can help, maybe some causes. How can people possibly dig themselves out of poverty?
Well, there are a few sites you can learn more about poverty, starting at CatholicCharities.org, but there's one called PovertyUSA.org. Understanding Houston is another site, and certainly the Kinder Institute. There's a lot of data out there about poverty. So, you know, if you hear someone saying, oh, the poor are lazy, they don't want to change their situation. I work with people who are in dire circumstances every day, and I could tell you that's just not true. So everybody I know wants to work and wants to help themselves and their family. So by knowing more, you can advocate for either better public policies or for the poor themselves. You can get involved. You can work at a food pantry. You can help mentor children. You can teach ESL. There's lots of ways to help the people who are living at the margins, right? And then also, you can donate gently used items that can go to the families that we help. You can donate needed resources to help the agencies who are there on the front lines helping the poor.
A few months ago, there was a story about a couple, I want to say here in Houston, that unfortunately died. This was during an extreme weather event. They were waiting to secure a loan to buy, it was either an air condition or unit or a heater. And instead of asking someone for the money again, they unfortunately passed away. So with that being said, you know, this is a touchy subject. Not many people are really confident about sharing that they're having financial struggles. So for those out there watching this who are dealing, you know, with a challenging situation but may not be so confident to speak up, what advice do you have for them?
Well, I know that it's hard to ask for help. It is. And for those of us that are in the helping profession, we acknowledge that. We want to help you just where you are and then work with you on goals for your life to help get to a better place for you and your children. So one place you can start is at CatholicCharities.org and learn about the services that we provide. And then if we can't help you, I promise that we're going to help you get to another agency that can. But there are agencies in town who want to help you. And we're here, and even if the agency you contact can't do it at that moment, they're going to find a partner that can.
Well said. Is there anything else you would like to add before we wrap up here?
I just want to say that there's hope. Sometimes when we're in dire situations, we can't see a way out. But I could tell you from personal experience that when we can help somebody find and obtain stable housing, when they can have their basic needs met, like food on the table, when we can help them access a job, all of those things are possible, and we, like Catholic Charities and others, we're here to help.
Well, I think that's a great spot to end the interview on. Thank you again so much for being here, and thank you for all that you do in the community.
Thank you very much.